everybody. I am Eden Espinosa, and I am playing Ava Perone in Studio 10 and T-Pac's production of Evita. We're here in Nashville. We're starting this vlog this week. That's what the kids are calling it these days. I'm going to show you around. I'm going to introduce you to people. I'm going to give you behind the scenes. Right now, there's a brush-up music rehearsal happening, and let's go check it out. Hey guys, back at rehearsal here in Jameson Hall. I am going to show you some costume designs. I'm going to introduce you to several people today, both creative and cast, so get ready. You're going to meet some peeps. All right, guys, here is the man with the plan. He is our fearless leader, Matt Logan, ladies and gentlemen. So, Matt, what do you do for this production?
I am considered the costume designer, the scenic designer, and the director of the show.
Tell us the thing you're
Hence,
looking for.
The crazy, yes.
Well, yeah. And the amazingly talented. What are you looking forward to the most about this production?
Opening night.
Ooh, I love
maybe
it.
Opening night. Okay. There's so many components and it's a lot, but man, as we've heard even this morning, the talent of this cast is so unfreaking believable that when we iron out all the little details, I cannot wait for an audience to
yes.
see
them.
Especially this one. This
Me? One. I'm going to play a game with everybody. Three rapid fire questions. I'm going to start with Matt.
Okay.
Matt.
Okay.
Favorite song?
Ever?
Yeah. First thing that comes to your mind.
Favorite song?
Favorite snack?
Favorite snack? Well, hot tamales.
Favorite color?
Favorite color? Black.
Spring or autumn?
Autumn.
All right.
Yeah.
First of many, coming your way. Hi, guys. I'm going to pop up on somebody and surprise him so you can meet him. He's the other man with the plan in charge of all of us crazies. Let's go see what he's doing.
Hey!
Hey!
What are you up to?
Oh, you know, just like looking at schedules, sending important emails.
Wow.
Welcoming Christy from T-Pac.
Christy from T-Pac, say hi
She's
to the vlog.
Best. Hello, vlog.
Hi.
Yeah.
So, do you mind
yes.
if I do a little...
Yeah,
a little...
do it. I would
so,
love to.
Please just tell us who you are and what part do you play in the show?
Oh, my name is Benji Hello. Kern, and I'm the production stage manager.
How's it going?
And basically my job is to make schedules and make sure people are safe and happy. Sort of like being like your mom. Like your mom who you like who makes you cookies a lot.
The show couldn't run without him. Seriously.
So, yeah, that's what I do.
What's been your favorite part of rehearsal process so far?
Oh my gosh, besides working with you.
Ah!
I think my favorite part is just working with such a large, phenomenal cast.
Okay.
And production team.
Cool.
And they're all such compassionate people who really love this art, and that makes it a joy to come in every day.
Cool.
Absolutely.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to do three pop questions.
Let's do it.
Ready?
Let's do it, yeah.
What's your favorite movie?
My favorite movie has to be The House Bunny.
Favorite topping on pizza?
A sausage.
Hugs or kisses?
Hugs.
Okay.
Most definitely.
That's Benji Kern, ladies and gentlemen. Bye.
Bye.
Let's sneak up on these cast members.
Well,
oh, hey, guys.
Peanut butter.
Hi. Hey.
Oh, hello. How are you?
He's just brushing his teeth, and we're talking about jam. So.
Oh, that's good of you before we go. So, do you guys want to, do you have time to do a little chit-chat interview with me?
I'd love to.
Of course.
Okay, so Please just tell me your name and your affiliation with the show.
Hi, I'm Andrew Morstein. I'm an interloper, mostly, just hanging out, creeping. I'm in the ensemble.
And?
And understudying the very great Ben Crawford as
yes.
Che. So, yeah, his favorite color is blue, and I'm a Pisces.
Oh, so he gave me more. He didn't wait for the questions. He
sorry,
gave me more.
I'm so
no,
sorry.
See how amazing on top of things he is? I'm just going to ask you, like, three quick questions.
Okay.
Give me the first thing that comes to your mind.
Perfect.
Okay? Favorite Christmas song?
Oh, Christmas tree.
Okay, great. Coffee or tea?
Coffee.
Spring or summer?
Summer.
All right.
Thank you.
That's Andrew.
Hi.
Hey, it's Ben Crawford. I just stole Eden's camera. Just look how pretty she is in her white dress right now. We're about to block High Flying Adored, so I'm gonna have to go. But I just want to let you know that I'm a thief, and I could steal things really easily.
Hey guys, don't mind me. I'm in my robe. We just
quit looking at her.
We're going to get to him in a second. We just finished rehearsing or blocking High Flying Adored, and I was wearing a rehearsal dress, and I was walking in very regal, and I tripped, and everyone laughed at me. Play the clip.
Did you get that?
Hey! Excuse me, sir.
Oh, hello.
Am I interrupting something?
Not at all. I'm just writing out my lines because I am studying.
What is this method that you're using here?
It's called the write out your lines method.
And how does it help you? You handwrite your lyrics?
You are handwriting the words that your character is saying.
And how does that help you? Why do you do that?
I feel like it's just another way to get them in my brain.
Okay. Well, introduce yourself. We've been talking to you for a little bit. Who are you?
Hi. You already know me because I stole the camera earlier.
Uh-oh.
But my name is Ben Crawford, and I'm playing Che.
In Evita.
Brigadoon Evita.
Right. And who's playing Evita?
Me!
Hey.
You don't even know.
Hey.
It's like stupid.
I have some questions for
you. Okay, what's that?
So far, what's been your favorite thing about working here in Nashville with TPAC and Studio 10?
Well, I can't just pick one thing. It's, we're like kind of out in like the middle of nature, which is amazing for rehearsals.
Super great.
It's pretty cool. This woman, Eden, is playing Evita, and she's ridiculous, and like we get along, and it's a lot of fun, and we're having a good time, and it's a fun, creative rehearsal process. So.
Great.
It's been really cool.
Cool.
Yeah.
So, can I shoot fire like three just like quick questions? Answer the first thing that comes to your mind.
Yes, go.
Hamburgers or hot dogs?
Hamburgers.
Favorite milkshake?
Chocolate.
Favorite dessert?
Ice cream.
What kind of ice cream?
Not picky.
Okay, there it is. Ben Crawford, ladies and gentlemen.
Me gusta helado.
He's.
Snapchat.
What's your name on Snapchat?
Benya Amin.
Today is press day. Look at this one right here.
Yeah, well,
movie star looks.
Yeah,
Anthony Crivello, Tony Award winner. We're gonna go do, it's dark now. We're gonna go do some interviews. An exciting day. So today is costume parade. We are in the costume shop where they build the costumes, where they have a huge storage of amazing pieces, vintage pieces that they've built, which is really exciting today because we're starting to get all our costumes together. Here is an inspiration wall that Matt used for some of like his color palettes, some of his designs, some of his fabrics that he wanted to use. You can see that overlay for the iconic white dress. And you can also see here just like swatches of fabrics, like color palettes that he wants to use for certain scenes. Now we're gonna head over to my rack of costumes. I'm just gonna show you glimpses because I don't wanna give anything away. I'm not gonna tell you what for, I'm not gonna tell you when in the show, but this is all mine. Look at the feathers, tick-a-tick-a-doo. This is one of my favorites. Some of these are actual vintage pieces. Oops, I just...
Tear it up.
I just knocked
just
it off.
Tear
Thank
it up.
You. Just Thank tear it you. Up. Please introduce yourself to our vlog.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie Wilkes, and I'm a production assistant and the hanger of things when Eden breaks them.
She's the best. Here's some of my suits. Here's some pieces from the iconic dress. It's so big. There's like three layers. Hoop, tulle, layer. It's super big. Here's some lingerie that you can't see. Those are my privates. What? But I didn't mean to say that. More robes and furs. This is one of my favorite pieces here. I'm not going to show you everything, but lots of great vintage suits, which are awesome. Furs and goodness. So one cool thing about this cast is we have a core ensemble of adults, and dancers and singers, and then we also have a huge group of students from Belmont University who get to be a part of this production and get experience on stage working with professionals while they're going to school, which is super great. These are some of our core members. I'm going to have them introduce themselves to you, and I'm going to ask them some questions.
Hi, my name is Bradley Gale, and I am in the core ensemble.
Yes.
And, that's it.
Okay.
I'm Neil Buckley, core ensemble, dabble in dance.
Dabble in dance, yeah.
Hi, I'm Laurie Gregoire, and I am one of the core dancers and dance captain.
Oh, there she is, keeping us in line, keeping it clean.
I am Eric Vega, and I am a core dancer.
Yeah, you are.
Keeping the core tight.
Yes, yeah. And you should see his arms.
Yes. And I am Anna Claire Hudgens, and I am also a core dancer.
Which, if you see my Snapchat, this is the woman whose spin class I took this morning. Go. Fish or chicken?
Chicken.
Chocolate or vanilla?
Oh, chocolate.
Spicy or sweet?
Sweet.
Coke or Pepsi?
Ooh, Coke, baby.
Oh, yeah. Shoot, I need to be better at my job.
Come on, girl, bring it.
I need to be better at my job. Heels or flats?
Heels.
Oh.
Says a lot about a woman.
Flats for me. Any favorite moments so far?
That time Evita fell.
Oh.
Roll the clip!
Brother Kemba, I have taken a keen study of you since after your birth, and I must admit that you are a real child of destiny. Physically, you are abnormally strong. You have a sympathetic heart, always fighting for justice for the less privileged. But I must tell you that the method you employ in achieving justice is rather cruel, uncivilized, and unscriptural.
Well, Buster, you know, it's written in the Bible that the kingdom of God suffered violence, and violence ticketed by force. I'm just taking justice by force.
You see, my brother, you are misinterpreting the verses of the Bible. Biblically, violence as it is written does not entail physical force, but spiritual. Now, you see, kingdom of God means your soul, and the struggle to protect it violently, just to keep with the word of God and be with him in the end, must always be spiritual. Now listen to this. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, I read. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Now, when you engage a man with blows, kicks, and strangleholds, you are wrestling against flesh and blood.
Well, Pastor, I'm sure you will agree with me that the physical is controlled by the spiritual, right? And very much so, what is obtainable in the spiritual also goes to the physical, right, Pastor?
You are being logical about the word of God. That is not how it should be interpreted.
Not so, Pastor. It's just that I just want you to reason with me, that's all.
Anyway, I just invited you here to advise you a bit. I beg you in the name of God, please be more reasonable in your quest for justice to the less privileged.
Okay, I've heard you. I'll do my best.
Are you promising me that?
I'll do my best.
Good. I know the Lord will do it for me. Let us pray. In Jesus' name,
amen.
In Jesus' mighty name,
amen.
Mighty Jehovah, thank you for this opportunity you have provided for us to discuss. I know you must, because you never mentioned what you have to discuss. It is not by might, it is not by power.
Make sure you extend it to that particular place. That is the boundary. You, up to that place.
What if you stop what you're doing?
I said stop what you're doing. If you don't get out from my land, Ikemba, I will make sure I stuff that your mouth with sand.
It's Yekalo. Believe me, it hasn't come to that yet. Because when it does, you will know that Ikemba fears no man.
Because you have not met the real man. Keep on walking, boys.
You guys touch one more grass there, and I swear to God, I'll make you regret that you came here this morning.
Fight the idiot. Beat him seriously. I will pay you double the money you have gained on this land. Beat him. Go and fight, my friend! Go and beat him! I said go and beat him!
Get him up for me! Get him!
Are you going to bring more boys?
I will report you to Igwe and make sure that you're seriously dealt with.
Get out of here now.
What are you doing here? What are you?
You can have your land back now.
Are you sure he's not coming back for the land?
Don't worry about him. You see, a dog that barks too much can hardly bite. Huh?
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, thank God. Let us go. Let us go.
Thank you.
When the Igwe ordered his guards to bring him back to the palace, he attacked and almost wounded them. But in my own compound, the council members almost banished him before I played. They have now warned that if he does such a thing again, they are going to give him outright punishment. Punishment without looking back.
Did Ikemba say that was in support of what he was doing?
I just told you what the council members told me. Just a messenger.
Okay. I'm going to disown Ikemba. Enough is enough.
No, he hasn't come to that extent.
I've addressed him as a father. He will not listen to me. I preached to him from the scriptures. Yes, he won't listen.
Eh?
Huh?
But Ikemba is you in a different body. So what you have to do is just to find a solution.
What solution? What solution can we be talking about? Eh?
Let me suggest. Why don't you send Ikemba overseas?
Yes, send him to go and study there. Or to go and become a businessman like you are.
Because once he's out of the entire Oga town, all this rubbish will stop.
Send him away. You think all this disgrace to my family will stop?
Yes.
I think you like it.
Send him away entirely.
Okay, well, this is a wonderful suggestion.
You see?
Thank you very much.
Yes.
I will do it.
Hey, did you come into this world to carry his trouble?
Please, send him away.
All right.
Thank you.
You have peace of mind.
Thank you.
I have. Everybody was happy.
Thank you.
Let me go and rest.
Oh, no. I just want to get something from the backyard for my dad. We're busy inside.
Okay, but you'll come back?
Yes.
Okay.
Any problem?
Look, I had wanted to discuss something with you. But I think we can do it next time.
Okay.
Next time.
Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you.
such an eyesore because these girls are not around to clean it up.
Okay, let's tell your father.
Okay, why don't you come inside?
You can see we have a fresh breeze here. You can see it's fresh.
Yes, so indeed it is. Okay, I'll tell you. Okay.
What is it about this boy? Achueba. What is it? What is his strength? What is the power behind it? Okay, I'm going to use a different means, a different trap, a different system.
Yes.
You sent for me?
Yes. Please sit down.
Okay.
I sent for you. There is something I want us to discuss. You're my first son. I'm getting old and weak. And I need someone to take over my business.
You want me to join in your business?
In fact, I'm sending you out of China to further your studies, to do your master's. That will put you in a stronger position to handle my business.
China? Of all places in the world,
yes.
China?
They are very good in electronics. In fact, I have already secured admission for you into Beijing University.
That's a joke, right?
Joke? It's not a joke, of course. I'm this serious.
Did you say Beijing University?
Beijing University. That's what I said.
Is that not the same university that Ugoma Uchendu got admission?
Uh-huh. You know it. You can see we already have somebody to keep you company there.
Well, very well, Papa. Think about it.
All right. Call up now to take me to my maternal home. I'm waiting outside.
Obinna! Obinna!
Chibuzo! What is it? What were you doing on that side? What's wrong? My son told me he saw you on a land that said never you step your feet on it again.
Man,
I've told you several times that that land belongs to me.
Who told you that?
My never give it to me. Who is your last father? Let me tell you, don't ever step your feet on that land again. I want to use it over my dead body. And I will never give that land for you. Over your dead body.
I said I will never give that land to you.
Over your dead body.
That land is my land. And I will never leave it to you.
So you want to die?
Man, you cannot do anything.
Huh?
Yes, you can't do anything.
Your name is Chibuzo. You answer Chibuzo.
Man, let me tell you, that land belongs to me. Iwalosi, you can't do anything.
Iwalosi,
you can't do anything.
Chibuzo. Okay, go there again. Anyone have a good one? I never call again. Anyone have a good one? Chibuzo, don't ever try it again. Iwalosi. Chibuzo wants to become Chibuzo. You will become Chibuzo.
Thank you.
is obstructing the moving train of Ukebo. Tell you what I say. Dance the drum of the shrine. Iwalose. Exactly, do you want?
Everybody knows that you took my turn to go to the city 36 years ago to do business. When our father sold the only land belonging to me to make you establish strongly in business. I allowed it not because I did not know my right, but because I loved you as a brother.
I still don't understand what you're talking about. Tell me, what exactly do you want?
Okay. With regards to such a rare sacrifice, I am asking that you give me one of your houses in the city, build one for me in the village, and then buy me a new car.
Okay. Why don't you just tell me you want me to set you up in a business instead of making it as if we're quarreling?
I've not finished. I'm asking in addition, the land at Ogariva. Then why don't you make me part owner of your business empire?
Okay, well, this is outrageous. Eh? You are my brother. And already you know that I have the interest of our entire family at heart. Huh? Eh? No. I'll grant all the demands except two.
Which two are those?
You cannot be a part of my company because it's a family business which I intend to hand over to Obi and Ikemba in the near future. Secondly, the only piece of land by Ugariba is the only one bequeathed to me by our father.
But you are not using that land at the moment.
I have so many plots in the village which I bought. If you want to farm on the land, why not farm on one of those lands? But not the one by Ogari River.
I can't give it up. Okay, do other things you said you want to go for me. But the ones you've not agreed upon, let me sit on it, as I say.
How is the going to go today?
All your father's life, I've always loved the mother. I've loved her, my other brothers.
anything about him or your entire family, it means his serious concern for me, serious interest.
You know, this is how I always intervened in all the cases he came behind me with the council members. This is why he traveled.
That's true.
Yeah. But for those interventions, he would have been banished and your father disgraced.
I know, Uncle. We are very, very grateful.
That's why the case of my demand is one good tone deserving the other. I am not making those demands as of right, but as a privilege. Just a privilege.
Yeah, Uncle, my father understands. That is why he sees it as a point of duty to make you and your other brothers economically independent. And of course, that was why he acceded to some of your requests.
But he didn't accede to the requests of the land at Ogariba. He did not.
Papa said that land is the only property he inherited from your late father. And he wouldn't like to give it to anyone, except us, his children. Uncle, if I may ask, why do you insist on the land?
The land is fertile, very fertile. I just want to farm on it. I love farming.
Just the farmer.
Just the farmer. That's all. It's not easy to get a fertile land in this our area.
Okay. I'll talk to my father about it.
Okay. Sure.
You how you work on the land. Okay. It's only farming you said you do on the land.
It's only farming.
Okay. There's no problem, Uncle.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And thanks for honoring my
Ukebu is my brother. Yeah? He's my brother. I know him too well. Why does he insist on that particular land? I offered him several other plots from which to pick if he's going to farm. Look, that land was an honor bestowed on me by our father. Ukebu cannot have it.
Papa, we're not
even any other man.
Papa, we're not using the land for anything. And we're not likely to in the near future.
Let it lie, Father. It does not decay. Or does it?
It doesn't, Papa. But you said you would bequeath the land to us.
Yes. Just like my father bequeathed it to me.
And then allow Uncle Ikebu to farm on it. But he's not taking it outrightly. Besides, I am old enough to know what transpired between the two of you if you're afraid of the unforeseen future. And I know he came by if he were around, would say the same thing.
Obi, Ukebu is my brother. I know him too well. Why does he insist on that land? Out of the whole lot I offered to him. You listen to me. I am your father. Just as my father deputed it to me, I will deputed it to you. Take the key and drive me to Mbazlike.
He's your brother.
Ejiro ke na edu onye ujo.
diga na abanti ka na abaji okodo koshime oguna fu dikite bi ajunishi mboshime na gana apo ekweshekwe ni tema mma baraji oruka kaka ebu gwalu shanyishike na mmapuru nko okunu shime mmebe omago mo memnu unu shime na nambe mme na nene neme nke munu ara go mare nu oru go jelu nje meka nje oke chala go odo nko na dum blavi na slora ni oru ngudi kije liye oru ngudi kije liye okome obo chota ka cha ali kliche ha wanyi na asi ya ah ah asu bo chota ka cha ali kliche
To this, to put it to God in prayer. He's able to do all things.
My word.
Nine.
Are you still here?
Yes, Nine.
Kiro, did you prepare something for her?
He's still on the fire, Nine.
Nine, that is what I'm waiting for. She insisted that I must eat before going home, so I'm waiting.
Okay, in that case, please wait.
Thank you.
Papa, what is it?
Ah, fine. My son. Let's go. Let's go.
I greet you.
How are you?
I'm fine.
I was actually coming to your house to see you before I met you.
Are you gonna
all is well.
I hope all is well.
Yes, all is
well. Okay. I'm gonna let's go.
No. It is about that your land at the end of the river.
Oh, can I zoom in river?
Yes. Yes. I want to build a factory on it. Actually, I have gotten all of that land already your own. It's just remaining yours.
Eze Mokrovia.
Eze. That land. I cannot sell it. And I won't sell it.
Why?
Imana, you know that is the only land I have. And that's the only property I have. And Amam, I know you have enough money to get land anywhere you want. I can easily help you out if you want me. But Efalama, I cannot sell it.
Uche.
I am ready to pay you anything. Just name it. 1 million, 1.5. Name it, and it will be yours.
Ezumakrovia. If not because I respect you,
I would have told you something you would not like. As you can see, you were going to my house. Amuam, I have other business to go. I have to go and tap my pound line.
Hey, Fana.
I will not sell.
You will not sell the land. Uche, think about it though.
Akko.
You know you need money.
You know, akko, akko.
You will not sell the land. Okay, now we'll see.
After the advice you gave to me, I went around the whole community meeting people that own portions of land around that area that I told you that I want to build a factory. So far, so good. They are cooperating. Except one boy. One boy that they call Uche. Okachi, the son of late Mazi Okachi.
And what was his response?
Igwe, he blatantly refused. Despite the fact that I promised to pay him double any amount he wants. Igwe, I need that land. I need that land desperately. I want you to use your power as the Igwe of this community to get that land for me. Igwe.
I am just
showing appreciation in advance.
That land is yours. Go and build anything you want on it.
Thank you so much, Igwe. Thank you so much. Igwe, as soon as I commence building, more good things will come your way.
Our ancestors will guide you.
You see? Igwe, I'll be on my way now.
Go in peace, my son.
Why are you doing me like that now, eh?
What about that fresh palm wine you promised me, eh? You didn't drink it again.
My brother, hey, when you were playing, don't be annoyed.
What is it? What's the problem?
It's Chief Tukau. What about him?
He conspired with Igwe and the Council of Elders to take over my land. And you know, that is the only land my late father left for me. Look at it now.
And the Igwe and Council of Elders supported him?
They did. They supported him.
Okay, you know what, let's go back to the palace.
Look, we have the support of the Igwe and the Council of Elders. There's no need for us to go there again.
Uche, listen, let's just go and see the Igwe. He might have a change of heart. You never know with these things. Except you try, you can never tell. Do you understand? Come with me.
I want to tell you people that as soon as I finish building my industry, no youths in this community will be left unemployed.
That's the development we are talking about. Yes, let me come to our place.
Yes, I went to see my friend, and he told me that Eze Umukurubia here snatched his land away from him, and that you are very much aware of this.
How dare you come into my palace and speak such despicable nonsense?
I do not care how despicable that sounds, but one thing is certain. Nobody will take my friend's land away from him and go scot-free. Have a nice day.
Ikoma!
Ikoma, come here! Come here! Igwe, please, don't be angry. Don't be angry. As you can see, he's still a small boy. Igbalosi! Ezumokobia,
you're joking.
Go ahead and do whatever you want to do on that land. You have our total support. Huh?
I heard you,
As for that idiot, I'm going to talk to his father. Please.
Okay, but I'm
listening.
I have respected Chifu Okonkwo enough.
We are all witnesses.
Next time his son misbehaves, I have no choice than to banish him from this village.
Well, I'll make sure it doesn't happen again, please. Please.
I will assign some of my DJs and guards to stay around while you are clearing that land, so that nobody will disturb you.
Igwe, you will live long.
I and the Igwe Itazo are behind this one. Yeah,
that boy cannot do anything at all. What can he do? And if he ever comes near here, only the gods know what I will do.
If he comes, Tower of London will not protect him against our revenge.
I even invited Nkume.
Nkume?
I invited Nkume. If somebody like Nkume comes here,
you know he's a bulldozer. He will bulldoze everything at sight. Yes. Nothing will obstruct him.
Nkume is a strong man.
Nkume is heavy duty now. moving train.
He can't do
it. What will he do? I thank you, my elders. I thank you. Thank you, my elders. Thank you so much.
We are totally behind you. Elders, let me go and answer the shrine.
Okay.
So the shrine is calling me.
Okay. Okay. We are here.
rain. Come in and leave this place now.
Kim, what are you doing here? What are you doing here? You think you're strong? You think you're strong? Get! Take care of him!
I warned you, stay away from this man. The next time I find you here, I won't take it like me. It will not be your guards, it will be you.
Kim, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Thank God, Nkume is here. Nkume, fight him. Fight him, I'll give you anything. Fight him!
Let him now.
You come kill him. Let me see you here again.
Ikemba, China will receive you with open heart.
Amen.
China will accommodate you with privileges.
Amen.
And China will send you back to your fatherland with blessings.
Amen. Amen.
You will return a captor of the golden fleece.
Amen.
You will return a man with super knowledge.
Amen.
And then you will be admired and celebrated by all and sundry.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jehovah.
Amen.
You will go in peace, stay in peace, and return in peace.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Okay. Mm. Thank you for the good wishes for my son.
Oh, yes.
My prayer is that your own son will one day go overseas to better his life.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So Ubin and I will now take him to the airport.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Plan number two executed successfully. Honestly, I fear this boy, Kemba. He was a terror to me. But he's gone now. His father and Ubi are no problem to me. I know how to handle them. I will handle them. Ibalosi. Ibalosi.
I can see you are so enthusiastic about going back to school.
Yes, Papa. It's my final year, you know.
I like the spirits. Mm-hmm. But make sure you study very hard.
Okay.
So that you can get very good results. This is the only thing that can make me happy. Okay?
Okay.
And remember to say your prayers always. This is very, very important.
Yes, Papa.
Okay?
I promise you, I won't disappoint you.
I know you will. In fact, I'm sure you're going to get very good grace, just like Obi-Man, he came out during their own time. Now, is there any other thing you want to take back to school?
No. No.
Are you sure?
Yes, Papa, I have all I need.
Good.
Gee, I'll be coming to visit you when you have seen this, okay?
Thank you.
I'll bring provisions for you, okay?
Thank you.
Remember to write me home.
I will.
And like Papa said, don't let the Bible out of your sight.
I wouldn't. Papa,
yes.
Once you get Buddy Kemba's address, send it to me so I can write him too.
Of course, I'll do that. Mm?
Okay, okay, Papa. Okay.
Now, come and kneel down so I can bless you.
Okay, Papa. Oh, Father, I thank you for my family. I thank you for these children. I'm begging you, Lord, as Jesus, to us to school.
Be great. The only voice of the gods of our land.
I hear you.
I greet you. The power that threats where no mortal threats, not even the Igwe.
You know, I hear you.
May you live long.
Okay, you are welcome.
Agaba.
So, how may I help you this time?
Agaba, I want to take what rightly belongs to me. I want my brother Okonkwo dead.
Okonkwo! Okonkwo! Here! Ike to Gonagbolaya. Mbani lazi. Ani abunanya. Ani abunanya. Obadike. Ike tu gona blanya. Ona podiki te bia junishi. Ani abunanya. Asino chipa ko keja magubo nyenga. Majaba ba na ko ifo me makwa kwa de lukwa ji. Ogu na gida na ke fo onya. Ha! Ogwa no mgba. Obo tulo. Otulo ya ni ime. Ime ya no tutu. Awa wo mbe mboso se ekpili. Ekpili naba. Ah! Okay, boo. It is a very, very easy thing to do. Very simple.
That's right.
I will invoke Okonkwo's spirit to appear in this mirror. When he appears, I will give you a knife to smash the spirit. And wherever he is, Okonkwo is a dead man. Alagani ku kwane meme. Alagodu no be. Ai we be to hono we. Yeah. Oh, Okonkwo. Okonkwo, appear! I put on the click. I turn the gun on. Okonkwo, appear! Appear! Mban. Okonkwo, I will check on Wani. Okonkwo, you can't get Nadi in a Wani and Kunu. You can't shake and Okonkwo and Abanya Vita Vita. I can't swear the manana. You can't click on the clip on the day to go to the news. Hey! Okonkwo, you will not be okay with that body. Okonkwo, I'm not going on. Okonkwo, appear!
What is happening?
Huh? Okay. Your brother, Okonkwo, has a very strong spirit guarding you.
Are you saying there is nothing you can do? Huh?
Nothing spiritual that I know of.
No. There should be a way out. Huh?
There is a glimmer of hope. There must be a way out. But you have to go and come back in 2 days' time. Eh? Don't put that there. I'm going to see you.
Once again, brother, I want to thank you for this big, wonderful gift you gave me. It's a big house in this city. I never expected such a big gift from you.
I intend to leave this for the other brothers.
When the house is finished, if you do it that way.
Huh? I invested virtually all I had in real estate.
You want to say?
I have 32 developments.
You want to say?
And 14 undeveloped
properties. You want to say?
Brother, God has blessed you wonderfully.
I thank God for you. Thank God for you. You did so much. But let me check this brother out.
Now they are mama. You know, you had all that and all you could give me was one house. Look at the car I have. Ikenna has overused it. It's been overused. Hey, brother.
Okay, boo.
I just thought I should speak out.
Yes,
I went to the site today. The boys there were doing a wonderful job.
As a matter of fact, I would ask you about progress on the site.
Ah, impressive. Very impressive. Ah,
I'm so happy. So, what are you eating like that?
Cola I bought from Afoga. Very sweet cola.
Cola? Cola I bought from Oga Market.
Is cola you're eating like dry meat?
No, let me give you a taste it. Have a taste of it. You see?
See? Ah, that's Oga Market.
Yeah.
And there I found that, you know, Uzuza leaf.
Yes.
Uzuza is equally sold there. Uh-huh. And if you use Uzuza and cook for people who are advanced in age, whatever illness they have will be healed. Then I found the addition again there. Obaka mbijo. If you eat soup cooked into Obaka mbijo, you will sleep and not wake up till morning. So it's not a soup you eat when you want to perform with your wife in the night.
You know that market is a village market. And you get to a bound to find all these
everything local and sweet.
I think I will go there in the afternoon. When I get there, I'll buy more things and bread for you.
Can bring him back.
Let me just hope that those you're talking about will come in and bring tangible money. Or that those who came yesterday and went without dropping money in that tray. They didn't drop money in that tray.
See, okay, I'm ashamed of you. Are we doing fundraising ceremony here or we are mourning our brother?
Oh, yes, sir. I don't blame you. You don't understand the way of the rich because you are poor.
No, I won't take that insult from you.
Look at you.
You call yourself a rich man.
Sit down.
You better go and apologize to the bank for calling yourself a rich man.
Okay, so sit
because
down.
Because you are worse than a poor man.
No, I'm not going to take any insult.
Sit down.
Sit down.
You are not going to carry for.
You are not
going to carry for.
Not come for quarrels. We came for money. Chinas and I are not interested in anything any sympathizer wants to give us. Yes, no amount of money, no amount of money they would be Papa back.
Sit down.
Please, money is not into us now. It's very, very useless.
Calm down now. Look at your younger sister, Gina. Be a man.
So it was your plan to keep me waiting?
Oh, I'm very sorry, Uncle. I was trying to tidy up things for the funeral.
Keep your sorry. Your father's burial and funeral arrangement will come up this weekend. Where is all the money given to you by sympathizers?
Ah, Uncle, I thought the family agreed to use the 1.5 million naira the general manager gave us to run the expenses.
What do you want to do with all the money given to you by sympathizers? A small boy like you?
Uncle, we are not quarreling. Anyway, I have already taken the money to the bank.
Bank? Into whose account?
My bank account. We're going to use the money for some other useful things after the funeral.
Obina, so you consider the burial of your father, a titled man, less important, less useful? Okay, I have used all the money, 1.5 million naira given to me by your father's manager. So I need all the money they gave to you to make up for the burial and the funeral.
Jesus Christ. Uncle, you have expended the whole money. Uncle, what award did you buy?
For you to ask me, a title man, that kind of question. Come, do you think I don't know how much they gave you? They gave you the sum of 525,000 naira. Yes.
They gave me 545,000.
Oh, I even made a mistake. Listen.
Give me all the money before noon tomorrow. All the money before noon tomorrow. Good night.
What is the meaning of all this? What kind of an uncle is this now? Chinasa!
I brought you.
Okay.
You're welcome. Sit down.
Obi, sit down. As you would have noticed, we, your late father's siblings, have been meeting here since morning. In fact, the topic of our meeting is centered on your family.
My family?
Yes.
And I was asked to leave just before the meeting started.
Okay, just hold it. But I summoned this meeting and I demanded that you leave because the issue at stake required matured minds before bringing you. So just, you're welcome. Just listen.
Thank you very much, Ichie Ukwebu. Obi, we have been discussing your father's assets. How much they are worth and how best to manage them after his death. At the end of our deliberation, we finally decided that it will be better managed by Ichie Ukwebu.
Uncle Ukwebu has no business experience.
Ebualose. No, that's an insult. No! Who taught your father business experience? Who made it possible for all the wealth he acquired, all the money he made? It was me. I made it possible.
Anyway, he never told me that. My uncles, if you had allowed me to be here at the beginning of this meeting, I would have told you one or two things that would have helped in shaping your decision on this issue. By the articles of registration of my father's business and asset, I, Obinna, in the absence of my elder brother, Ikemba, should take control of everything.
Obinna.
Ichie Ukwebu told us all these things, and we are not disputing that fact.
Yes.
But the fact remains that you are a minor and could easily be swayed. We can't leave all these assets in your care. Because if anything happens to it, the spirit of your father will not forgive us.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And even Ikemba, when he comes back, will not forgive us. Ichie Ukwebu is not taking everything per se, but he's just there to look after it until Ikemba comes back and you're wise enough to take control of it.
Let me just say, it's a big assignment I never expected. But because of pressure from elders and then the tradition, I wasn't expecting this. It's not easy.
Why don't we leave the day-to-day running of my father's businesses and assets in the hands of the managers who have been working for my father before he died? While Uncle Ukwebu and I do the oversight functions.
No, you see why we say that you're still a young boy? Yes. You're still too small to understand. Let me tell you, if we do it the way you have suggested, I bet you in 3 months' time, the whole world will vanish. History would not record me that I was there and it happened and I allowed it. It wouldn't be good on my side. Well,
my uncles, since you have all agreed, I have no choice than to do your bidding. I will hand the documents over to my uncle Ukwebu.
You are the son of your father.
I see Solomon's wisdom in you. That is Solomon's wisdom. Well, I see.
Oye kichori imu, oye aruru ala, lenu ya kona vya, paduka na ya, okwa madubo na ladima, piko uche aria, makachoko ga kuboru.